Hey everyone, Eric Albrecht here. So I am doing a vlog for creating my famous, yet to be famous, French onion soup. Everybody that's tried it absolutely loves it. So we have our broth. This is currently just broth. It's not homemade. It is just the store-bought beef broth. And in the other pan here, I am just melting some butter. The broth, in case you're curious, you can use any broth. Usually we go with a low sodium broth, but this is Knorr's beef broth. So use whatever you like. And the onions, I usually do about 3 medium onions. Now these are pretty small onions, as you can see. So we actually have 5 of these small ones. So I'm gonna cut these up fairly, not too fine, but you know, somewhat fine. Not gonna dice them, just slice them up real thin, and we're gonna melt them, saute them in the butter, which I'm gonna brown a little bit before I put it in there. I don't wanna burn the butter, so I'm just putting it on a short simmer right now just to melt the butter, and then when I'm ready I will brown the butter and put the onions in. Alright, so I got the onions sliced up. You can tell I've done about an inch in length, and the thinness, just one layer. And not diced, but it's a nice little length here. So it seems like a lot of onions when you look at the bowl. But these, when they're sauteed, are going to lose a lot of their volume. So right now I'm just browning the butter. Don't want to burn it, but we're just going to brown the butter, and that's going to add some extra flavor to the onions. Once I add the onions to it and I stir them up a little bit, I'm going to add some white wine to that, and that'll just help with the flavor as well. So once those are finished sauteing, then I add the onions over to the beef broth. Okay, so the butter is browned. I'm going to go ahead and add the onions to the browned butter. Put that down for a sec. And we just want to mix that up. We don't need to cook it on too high of a temperature right now, so sauteing temperature for me, that's probably going to be about a 3. And yeah, so if you're using a steel or a Teflon pan, your temperature is probably going to be a bit higher. For me, I'm using cast iron and it's preheated, so it retains the heat a lot better. So I can usually cook at lower temperatures than other people can. So that's mixed in pretty good there. I'll let that saute. And I'll just go ahead and add some white wine. So with the white wine, there's going to be no set measurement. And just buy whatever cheap stuff you have. So you don't want it to be terrible, but this is just a Tosca cooking wine. Don't add too much, but add just enough to let it saute with the onions and the butter. That should be enough. And that'll add a very nice flavor for the sauteed onions. And when this is done sauteing, you don't want to saute it too long. Like, we don't want mushed onions. You still want texture with your onions in the French onion soup. So we'll saute it for a bit. We don't want our onions to be too crunchy still. So saute it enough where they're going to be a bit soft, but you still want a little bit of like crunch texture, but not crunchy. That's when we're going to be adding them to the broth.
Oh, there.
Because in the broth, I mean, you have to cook it for many hours for it to really go from the raw crunchy to a nice edible texture. So I'll let that go for a bit, and we have the ingredients for the herbs, which is going to be added shortly here. So we're adding 1 teaspoon of thyme. What's next?
1 teaspoon of basil.
Basil? So 1 teaspoon of basil. I can smell the sauteed onions already. I mix them every minute or two. Probably don't really have to. But I can tell they've already lost some of their volume. And they'll continue to lose their volume, and I can tell they're a little bit softer already. Child just went to the bathroom. Okay, Trinity, mommy will help you in a minute.
Yeah.
So this is the 1 teaspoon of basil. So I forgot to add, I put in quite a bit of butter to this. So we usually buy the sticks of butter, and I always do the unsalted because I don't like the salt so much in all of our cooking. I like to add the salt myself. So unsalted butter, I didn't add a full stick, but I added about 3/4 of a stick to this. And that butter, you'll get that butter flavor in the French onion soup as well, so it'll be a nice complement along with the wine that I put in here. You saw the butter browning. It was just the portions of it that I didn't mention. So that's about 3/4 of a stick of butter. Brown the butter, add the onions, and then the white wine. So here we have
marjoram.
1 teaspoon of marjoram. Next we have 1 teaspoon of black pepper. So for the black pepper, you don't really want to be biting into that in your French onion soup. So try to grind it fairly finely if you have peppercorns. Otherwise, you can use the ground black pepper that you can buy pre-ground. That's usually pretty fine. So go ahead and add that. Next we have a 1/2 teaspoon of smoked paprika. So this isn't regular paprika, this is smoked paprika, just 1/2 teaspoon. I kind of eyeballed it there. So next we'll be adding 2 tablespoons of brown sugar.
Oops. This is brown sugar.
The brown name?
No, it's just called best brown sugar.
Oh. I don't think it really matters, it's brown sugar. Next we have 2 tablespoons of sherry wine.
Oops. Yeah. Making a snowman.
Next we're adding 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. Next, we're going to be adding some garlic. So I cut up some fresh garlic. You could use 1 clove, 2 cloves, use your judgment. So I'm just going to be mashing them up with the garlic masher thing, whatever that's called. And I'll put that directly into the broth. So the next thing that we're going to be adding is bay leaves. And for the bay leaves, I don't really have a set number that I use, but we do have a metal hanging thing.
It's a T-ball.
A T-ball. So just pack it in fairly tight into the T-ball, and then the T-ball has a little hook that you can hang on the edge. of your pot. So I forgot to mention here, the type of garlic that I used was elephant garlic. Don't ask me why I like to use elephant garlic, I just do. You can use whatever garlic you want. And I think we are ready to go ahead and add the sauteed onions to the broth. So these are a lot softer. They're starting to get a bit more kind of golden, I think. You giving Dora a horse piggyback or a horse ride?
A horse ride.
Okay, a horse ride. So we've reduced or evaporated away a lot of the, cooked away a lot of the wine and butter. So I'm pretty happy with how this looks right now. So we're going to add that to the soup. Hey, Trinity.
Is it cooking?
Yes, Daddy is cooking. Oh. Dora, want to smile for the camera?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's a beautiful smile. All right.
I can tell Dora.
No easy way to add this, so I'll just add it that way.
Dora.
You're going to carry Dora?
I got to carry Dora.
Dora will hurt herself with the cars.
Yeah.
Well, you gotta keep her safe.
Yeah,
she has to hold your hand.
Huh. He's little. Her hand is little now.
Her hand is little?
Yeah.
Or have you grown and your hand is bigger? Your hands can carry her now?
Yeah.
Okay, we got most of these onions out. Just a few left. She hurt herself with the cars. Now it's the easy part. We can just close the lid and let that simmer. So this is a cast iron, what's it called? Self-basting lid. And it's got a pretty good seal so no steam will get out and it'll just keep that moisture in. For me, I can probably, depending on how long I decide to cook it, for there you go. So for the temperature, if you're just doing like 2 or 3 hours with the lid on, I mean, I'm guessing you could probably get away with like 4 or 5. I'm gonna be cooking it at about 2 or 3 for a couple hours in this, and it should be fine because we did saute the onions. So it's just to get some of that flavor out of the different herbs that we added. So the next thing that we're going to be adding is the cheese.
Oh no, she's
hurt herself in the car. I'll give her a kiss.
She hurt herself by herself in the car.
So I like to get pretty good cheese. This is Zapato tradition. And it's shredded mozzarella. You can grate your own mozzarella too, it doesn't really matter. And we'll get to the next steps once we start with cooking with the oven. So while we're waiting for the French onion soup to simmer in the cast iron pot, I have some fresh homemade bread here. I did a thick cut, kind of like Texas toast style. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna toast this. We don't want a like a burnt toast. It can be like a light toast, but light to medium toast. And once it's done toasting, we can cut it up into croutons and let it sit out while the French onion soup is simmering. We're not too worried about the toast getting a little bit hard as it sits out in the open, because once it's added to the broth, it will end up getting soft and mushy anyway. We do want it to be a little bit hard when we add it to the soup, otherwise it's just gonna sink from the weight of the mozzarella that we add on top of it. So I'm just using a toaster oven. I don't know what you'll use. And for me, let's see. Add that to about halfway and we'll just let that go. So our bread is done. As you can see, it's a kind of a medium toast, I guess. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna slice it up over here into croutons. See, I don't really have a good way of doing this. That's not too bad. And if I move it, it's got most of the cutting board actually. So for the size, you don't want it too big, because if you do it too big, it's going to end up just expanding to the size of the cup. And you can kind of base it on the size of your cup as well. For the most part, you can kind of do it like large croutons. You can get different sized croutons, so that's why I said large. And remember, this is cut as a Texas thick cut bread, so it will expand more, even though you're doing it as sort of crouton style. And it's fine if we just let this sit for a while and get a little bit hard, that's fine. I don't mind that. So we'll let that sit. We can spread them apart. And just have to wait for our soup now. One of the things I can do is show you the cups that we'll be using. I have these soup mug cups. They're pretty awesome. But a lot of you are probably going to be familiar with more your standard small size soup cup. So you can use either or. And if I compare these for the croutons, let's see, then if that's the large cup, we'll be adding probably about 5 or 6 of these. If we're doing it for the small cup, maybe about 4 or 5. So works out pretty good. And with that, we'll wait for the next step. So I've already added the croutons into the soup. They're completed with the cheese, looks like this. I have the oven currently set to broil. Not too much cheese, otherwise it will just sink, and then the cheese doesn't really brown. Okay, Trinity hot. And of course, practice any kind of caution. I like to get this to a nice golden brown. Sometimes, I mean, it's okay if you even burn it a little bit. Now, with the light on, you won't really be able to see anything if you have large cups. So you are just gonna have to check it every couple of minutes. It doesn't take too long though. Aurora! Aurora! See cheese! picture for Aurora, and how about Smokey? We can do a quick look at the cheese here. So yeah, the cheese is melted, but it hasn't started getting golden brown yet, so we have to wait. So I forgot to mention here, we decided to let our soup sit overnight. So because we let it sit overnight, we did lose some of the liquid, so I actually added a fourth carton of beef broth, and it didn't dilute it at all, I don't think so. So it should be still nice and flavorful, tasty. And the soup is just about done here.